Alright guys, gals, and everything in between, so I'm doing a bit of a different video for you today, because as you guys know, I don't do that many speculation videos about movies in the way of a lot of the stuff like that with the marketing, but there is one movie franchise that I do it for, because when I was younger and watching them back in 2008 and 2007, that was like the thing to do, was to watch all the speculation videos on Cloverfield. So here I am with a speculation video on Cloverfield. Now that we kind of have a little bit more information heading up to what I'm calling Cloverfield God Particle. Cloverfield God Particle, we, through Swagbucks of all things, got a plot synopsis for the movie. Now, we can't tell if it's 100% confirmed or not, but we do know for a fact that the film is set during apocalyptic war amongst people, so it looks like between the Russians, the Chinese, the Americans, Europeans, etc. Like a third world war breaks out due to an alien invasion that had happened. They are up in a space station and they believe that they have cracked potentially a code that could help save humankind, but the Earth disappears. So the Earth disappears and they have no clue what to do, and then all of a sudden they get contact from another ship. And the ship pulls in and they have to fight to survive. Now I'm paraphrasing what was given. I will provide the other one on screen, but I am very intrigued by this plot synopsis. Why? Because it looks like one of the largest connecting veins of the Cloverfield universe. Because as you guys know, I was speculating probably about, what, 2 years ago now, on how all of this stuff tied in as a Cloverfield cohesive universe, as the Cloververse. But I think this is one of the ones we're gonna see connecting ties. And here's why. Because the alien invasion that happened, well, we just saw an alien invasion in 10 Cloverfield Lane. And 10 Cloverfield Lane, the creatures were decimating, it looks like, the entire southeast and southwest. We don't know to the length of the destruction that had happened, but it looked pretty grim, we should say. Right there, post an alien invasion, that would be probably another connecting vein. Whether they directly reference it or not in the film may or may not happen, but it would be very interesting to see those connecting veins start to click, because as you guys speculated, and as I speculated, the aliens from 10 Cloverfield Lane are at least somewhat influenced by the events of Cloverfield. One of the theories that I have most stuck onto is the fact that they are some of the people watching over the fact that the Cloverfield monster was a baby. That's where I'm at right now, where it's like the aliens then get mad that we killed it, come on in to rain hell. And I believe I speculated that in my video. I haven't watched that video in a while. Thank you to all of you who viewed it. So if I'm wrong, feel free to correct me, but I don't think it's that big of a deal. But it's a theory that I've held on to, that that was essentially our Mothra standalone film, was that this is another creature type that we're going to get in this Cloverfield universe. Now, are we going to get new creatures in the God Particle or Cloverfield God Particle? I don't know. I imagine we're going to get new creatures, but at least enough connecting vein references to keep it going. Right now, if you ask me, the full cohesive story that we have going on right now is that the events of Cloverfield happen, the aliens were spectating and watching the gestation and birth of the Cloverfield creatures. One of them got birthed a little too early, because it's obvious they had to be at least somewhat close to Earth. So they then are on their way, and they find out that we killed the Cloverfield monster. Even though the post-credits do say help us slash it's still alive, J.J. Abrams has since said the creature is dead. I don't necessarily subscribe to that theory. I think if we get one back, it might be a new creature, but it's still, the Cloverfield monster has to have some place somewhere in this universe. So the aliens come through, they get mad, they come and start attacking us and essentially trying to clean up shop. So Howard already knew about this because he worked on satellites, the satellite which got knocked out of the sky, which belongs to the Taguato Corporation. And the Taguato Corporation was already working with the Cloverfield Monster, so we already know they have prior knowledge. That's where things like Slusho come from, which the viral marketing has since kicked off for Cloverfield God Particle, where they're giving out, from what I'm told, Snapchat codes at random cities that are next to nuclear power plants. Now, if we're in like a World War III scenario, the nuclear power plants would come into play. Howard, getting prior knowledge, where would he get that prior knowledge? He would get it from his friend, which we already know from the ammo tin that they got in the viral marketing of the last one, that Howard kind of already knew the aliens were coming because he has a buddy who works up on a space station. And so since his friend works on the space station, that is our connecting vein to Cloverfield God Particle. One of those people on the space station is going to end up being a friend of Howard's. And they already knew, which is where I want to, it keeps digging at me. I can't help it. No one ever brings it up. But Emmett in 10 Cloverfield Lane says that you should hear his Howard's theory on mutant space worms. And I can't help but even though it was a funny line, that was that a hint to Cloverfield God Particle that maybe the monster, the primary monster we're going to see, is going to be a mutant space worm? That maybe those things driving the ships that are biomechanical are actually space worms? It's entirely possible. We don't know entirely, but I think we might get a couple more answers in this film. Although, based on the plot synopsis that we're looking at, there's not really going to be a giant monster yet. It looks like it's going to be more in the vein of The Thing, where there's mysterious deaths. It could almost be like a bacterial thing, where we're getting, there's something inside of people, it's like a body snatcher scenario. It's hard to tell with that, but I can't help but shake the fact that I feel like this is going to be much more like The Thing and less like a giant monster movie. Although the mutant space worms would come in at the very end, I'm assuming, or the alien crafts from 10 Cloverfield Lane. Either this is going to set up 10 Cloverfield Lane, or it's going to follow immediately afterwards. Because you could test the theory that they get warning, he warns Howard, the aliens come in and start invading. But if the aliens already invaded, like the synopsis says, then it will be a continuation of sorts of the Cloverfield universe post the alien invasion. But I think that it's all too coincidental to say these are not connected, because we do know for a fact that they are connected. Abrams has said that while they are technically in a way separate, they are still connected in the same universe. I am still a big believer in this whole universe is all directly connected. And now that we're getting into things like the Earth disappearing, we're going to start seeing those alternate timeline kind of fluctuations. I think we're about to get some really weird stuff. And now we also have the prequel film coming up, or it might not be a prequel film for the next Cloverfield film. They're speculating it is a film called Overlord, which is going to take place in World War II, where they're in a village where there's some shenanigans going on that are not of this world. Some people have speculated it's going to be a zombie film. I really hope not. But there's nothing really to go on yet, other than I believe that will be the origins of Taguato's knowledge of things like the Cloverfield Monster to get the sea nectar for Slusho. So I think that that's where that story is going to go. But as for Cloverfield God Particle, I think we're looking at a major connecting tie to this universe, hence the delays. I think they pushed the film back further in order to work on the special effects and to enhance the ties in the Cloverfield universe. And now that we have the Slusho truck driving around, I haven't heard any activity from it in a little while, but I'll keep you updated. If I can get one in my hometown, I will gladly go and get information for you all. But anyways, do you guys think my speculation is accurate? I will, of course, review every trailer that comes out for it. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Got plenty more videos coming to you. Love you guys.